Hello, welcome to the MOOC Circular Economy for Sustainable Built Environment of the Faculty of Architecture at TU Delft. The MOOC is addressed at students of bachelor and master level, but also to professionals who want to gain insight to a new approach to building and city design. The built environment is the place where we spend the largest part of our lives. We experience it as a succession of places and spaces. Its quality has a great impact on how we define ourselves, how we act and feel. But it also concerns technical aspects. What technical solution we offer determines how our buildings will eventually perform over the whole life cycle. That is important because cities make a huge impact on our environment. Building construction is responsible for about 40% primary energy use, 26% material resource use, and 35% waste generation. So we can say that our built environment is a collection of materials and components that are assembled in a more or less efficient way. And next to materials, we also have water, energy, and waste that enter, circulate, and leave the urban environment every day. We are creating a negative impact, and this impact is huge. Here at the Faculty of Architecture, we believe that circularity is one of the solutions which can lead to minimizing of this impact and one of the most relevant topics of a sustainable development. But the implementation of this concept poses a huge challenge. Currently, we are living in a linear building economy which uses raw materials to produce constructions that are turned into waste at the building's or component's end of service. The use phase of a building is by far the longest, averaging 60 years or above. That makes a big difference if you compare buildings, for example, with mobile phones or other consumer products that have a lifespan of only a couple years. In the context of the environment, we are making decisions that will take effect in the far future when the next generations will have to deal with them. Circular economy aims at closing the loops and instead dispose, eliminate the waste by intervening in each of the life cycle stages of a product. If we are working on a transition towards a circular built environment, how can we actually close the loops and feed used materials and components back into the building process? How can we close water, waste, and energy cycles to minimize systemic losses? Basically, we have to tackle two aspects. On one hand, the gigantic stock of buildings that reach the end of their life and need renovation. And on the other hand, we have to create new types of concepts for buildings today, so that these are fit for the future and can be redesigned, upgraded, or disassembled without creating waste. It becomes clear that this strongly relates to a number of systemic levels, and in the coming weeks, we will guide you through those levels and show their interrelation. Next week, you will learn about materials and products, the base ingredient of buildings, and how they relate to a circular performance. We will scale up to the building level in week 3. A building is an assembly of a large number of components. To help us understand the hierarchy, we will use Stuart Brand's theory of the shearing layers with different life cycle durations. The city scale is discussed in week 4, when we will explore the three most important resource flows that enter, circulate, and leave the urban environment every day: water, energy, and waste. As a reference, we will use a typical Dutch city. In week 5, we will focus on the regional scale. We will explore the characteristics of the urban metabolism and the importance to investigate economic activities to identify the flows and stocks of materials, products, and waste. We need innovation on different aspects. We need new building technologies and design strategies. These must include sustainable resources and flows throughout the entire life cycle. The societal dimension of a circular built environment is huge, as many stakeholders are involved. To align new solutions with economic incentives is a key element for implementing a new approach. Finally, governance and management will play a huge role in the transition towards a circular built environment. With this MOOC, we will introduce you to the basic terminology of a circular built environment. You will learn and understand systemic relations of different levels: material, product, building, city and region. And by showing relevant cases, you will be introduced to the state of the art in a circular built environment. This MOOC will enable you to join the debate and start to create a more circular built environment. As I have mentioned before, the urgency is high, but we have just started to explore how these principles can actually get implemented into the building realm. It needs a huge combined effort by all stakeholders if we want to reach the goals of a sustainable future.